Hello everybody, thanks for coming to see our Professor Young, who's from National Taiwan University of Science and Technology. So Professor Young got the prestigious European Commission Maria Award for his research, and we're privileged to see your research, which has been going on for years. I can see since 2009 you have been interviewed by a Discovery Channel, so we've got a famous person here who's been on TV before. So he's going to talk about energy generating glass, which is also thermal insulating. So Professor Young managed to combine the attributes of two, that is energy generating as well as energy saving attributes, into our glass and window. So without further ado, I'd like to welcome you, Professor Young, and we'd love to hear what you have to say on your project. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I'm very happy to be here to introduce this product for you. Maybe we can have some cooperation in the future. In the morning, I'm a student to hear about your research. I find a very good idea because we have many opportunity for cooperation, because your fundamental research is like Intel, and my research is like Apple. So your invention, your development, and give me, and I will combine together to become a very popular production for the user. So I think it's a very good opportunity for cooperation in the future. And also, I will thank to NEP2 of our country. Actually, my boss is over there. He's very kind, accompany me to be here, because we fly a long way, 9 hours on the flight. So thank you for my colleague and my boss. Okay, so actually, the product here is a kind of application for zero energy building, because it is a tendency. I think we do everything here, both you and me, is for the next generation a better environment. Okay, so I would like to introduce me by Alan, by Discovery Channel, and in this report, about 4 minutes, and he introduced briefly my product.
In Taipei, Taiwan, there may just be a solution. Young Chin-Huai is a researcher at National Taiwan University of Science and Technology. He's attempting to find ways to capture solar energy more efficiently.
当太阳照的时候呢，它会产生热，所以热本身呢就会影响半导体的发电，所以那个电呢会下降。另外一个就是它表面会容易覆盖灰尘。
In enclosed spaces such as buildings, this solar inefficiency worsens.
太阳能如果架在户外，那没问题，没有热传导的问题。可是你如果要用在建筑的材料，你不能让它产生热，所以这时候呢，你就要用一个技术，让它把热这一个功能呢，要把它隔绝掉。
Now, Young has an inventive solution. A three-layered solar photovoltaic structural glass he terms the miracle glass. This may radically change the way future cities are built.
思维一个问题，就是说我们的建筑物本身啊，就要让它发电。那建筑物本身的发电呢，就其中就有屋顶的发电，那还有一个就是玻璃的发电。那我们这个技术呢，主要是用来做玻璃的发电。
Within each glass is a semiconductor that converts solar energy into electricity. But the glass also does something else. It reduces heat.
它主要的特色是，我们在这个玻璃里面呢，我们就在这个光电玻璃里面呢，我们有多了一个反射的技术。当光照过来的时候呢， 它会折回去，让前面的这个太阳能的半导体呢会多一次的发电，这样的话可以增加10%的电力。
Three different rooms with three different scenarios. The first with a regular glass window. The second with a commonly used photovoltaic glass. And the third with Young's Miracle Glass. Temperatures in each room are recorded. The room with the Miracle Glass records the lowest temperature in the summer.
Okay. Now, the actor of the movie appear here to introduce for you about this glass. Actually, we try to apply all the technology in the world together to present a useful solution for human beings. This is our glass. Actually, it already some application. For example, is in my university, and we have a different see-through for 10 or 5 or 20, 50% see-through. What's the difference about crystal? Some crystalline solar cell could be put on the roof or solar power station, but my market is focused on the building. And for Shisu, for example, for windows, for skylights. A very important issue. And as I stay in Europe 2 years, and everybody try to say 2020 or 2025, let the unit meters, 1 meter square in the building try to reach 0 to 25 kilowatt hour per meter square per year. And currently, most of the family like in the label of DEF, but we try to upgrade to A plus or A in 2020 or 2025. You need to do two things. One is how to decrease in energy consumption. And another is how to increase in renewable energy. And in the morning, I see many technology of yours. You try to do this one. So actually, for the total solution, we need to do two things together. You cannot reach the target independently. You need to do together. This is my philosophy. So, what is the menu? How to present a good total solution for the human being to reach the zero energy building? Okay, very clearly, in the morning, you do many technology to increase the renewable energy supplies. And my contribution is how to decrease. But not only this, I try to do an effort to 1+1 bigger than 2. This is my idea. Okay, so how to reach the target? The first, I think in your technology, you know many about this. From one layer to two layer. This is the first stage. And another stage is, for example, inside the glass, we also do something inside. One is a silicon film, is a tandem idea to increase the solar power. And also, we have two airspace to reduce the heat transmission. Also, a reflection layer to reflect the light, including visual light and infrared light, to increase the solar power up to 16%. And at the same time, it can do a very, very good insulation to saving heating, saving cooling. And this is my idea. So I think there will be many collaboration in the future for us because I listen to your technology, something for like that. Okay, so the technology, we do two very good contributions. One is we increase the solar power, and there is the actual solar power for the window, on the window size. And this is another contribution. We reduce almost 6 times of heat penetration. It's very important because we say our philosophy is we do this, and we try to 1+1 and bigger than 2. Okay, so you can see after the technology, almost all the spectrum to absorb by the solar cell and to do a very good solar power generation and a very good heat insulation. I just to bring some demo kit here to do the demonstration for you, like here. And I would like to ask Anita for me to tell your feeling to everybody, okay? Thank you very much. Okay, so, okay, no, you just, you don't need to put here. It's okay. Okay, here, this is a simulation, it's a demonstration. And could you please put your hand here? And your hand here? You're here? And here?
Yeah. So you can feel, yeah, it's warm there.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think
it's not warm. Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you very much, because I think Anita is an honest person. Yeah. And another. Please tell everybody the digital. This is a solar meter. It's a 16.
16.0 watts per square meter.
And how about this?
700 watts per square meter.
Yeah. So, thank you, Anita.
No worries.
Yeah. This why I need to bring this all over the world because I try to let everybody know it's a real, not only a slide. So the insulation will up to 20 times, near 20 times reduced. So it's very important, this idea. We need to do things together. One, increase solar power. Another is decreasing the heat penetration. According to the idea, most of the architecture, they want to do what's behavior in the real space. So I'm very happy to, I have financial support from NEP2, and also I have a budget of European. And we set up two real glass house to compare. Okay, so you can see this. The glass is a very less heat penetration. You can see the camera here on the roof is a low house. The roof is very high temperature in the room is near to 50 degree. And our roof is the temperature very steady. That means almost no heat penetration into the house. Another solution is when I stay in your country, maybe you have autumn and springtime, we have a solution for the house because we don't use air condition because it's a very good insulation. We just use ventilation. You see here the ventilation system, and it can lower down the temperature near to the outdoor temperature to get a very comfortable inside. Otherwise, for normal glass, the normal glass is like this. Appear here, you can see many places in Australia. So you can see the glass, and the temperature could not go down. So you need to turn on air condition. So, 1 year record, we can save in 50% air condition. Okay, so the idea is why? Why you can save in air condition? You see, when you visit our demonstration site, you can, most of the time, our glass house is cooling down by meditation. But another house, you see, you need to cool down by air condition. So it's very interesting. I get a very surprise result. These days is a very all day sunny day, but I think in Sydney or in Canberra, it's almost every day. But in Taiwan, it's sun, maybe one week, one day. So I think here is a very good place for develop this kind of glass. You see the day is in June. The air conditioning on for the Roy house is 8.4, and mine only 0.1. Why? Because most of the time I use the technology, we use the meditation system. You see the meditation system 3.4, and then 1.6. So totally, for one day consumption, the Roy house by 10 kilowatt hour, and we 3.5. So for energy consumption, we reduce one third, two third. And another benefit is, you see here, we can generate 4.7 solar power. So 4.7 solar power can supply 3.5, and we have remaining 1.2 feedback to the grid. So the difference is normal house 10 from grid, our house is a 1.2 send back. Quite different. It's a real so is a I record this video for everybody. We have three houses. This is the structure of the glass. And we set a comfortable environment, and all the facility they can automatically do for environment, comfortable meditation or air conditioning. This is the ordinary glass. You see the fan system, but the fan system closed, but the air conditioning turned on due to indoor very hot. Another house is a so-called Roy house. Also, inside is also very hot. So you see the main fan system and the meditation system closed, and the air conditioning turned on. So that means Roy and the normal glass very hot inside. This is our glass. You see the meditation system turned on. Just do air circulation, and you can get a very comfortable environment. Okay, three houses. One is a normal glass, and a Roy glass house, and is our glass. Also have the same solution, the result. For normal glass, 3 kWh per day, and for Roy glass house, 2.2 kWh. And for us, we have remaining 0.3 can send back to the grid. So that's why I say, if the every day is sunny day, and the outdoor temperature is okay, it's not so hot or not so cold, we have remaining power to send back to the grid. But for from January to July, before I come here, the record is for my house, we need 26. From grid, for Roy house 271, and the ordinary house 356. So we can save in 93% power from the grid. So it's a really very exciting result for the building. Okay, so compared with a normal PV like this, is a we can do a full see-through like this. And the problem of the normal PV, when we apply on the glass, you need to do insulation. Otherwise, the indoor will be very hot. This is a building in Taiwan. During the summertime, it's up to 38 degree. So up there, they use the curtain to do insulation. So I want to understand why the normal PV very hot inside due to when the semiconductor work, it will become very hot. So the indoor will become very hot, so you need to more air conditioning to cooling down. But our product, we have a very good insulation. So the air conditioning consumption almost 2 times difference due to it's very hot of the normal PV. Compared with low-E glass, yes, we do a long-term monitoring. Low-E glass can save 9% air conditioning, and we can save in 52. Okay, this is daytime. Actually, it's very bright. Okay, some architecture worry about it's very dark indoor because it's a semiconductor installed here. So in Taiwan, many architecture doubt if I use your glass, maybe it's very dark during the daytime. I say no. I just introduced there to my house. You can see for normal glass, the brightness were up to 4,000 lumination, 40,000, and the hours only 2,900. What difference? For this lumination, it's very good for eyes. You don't need to turn on any lamp. But for this lumination, it's some damage to our eyes. So actually, this is like an electronic screen. You don't need any curtain. When I reach the camera during the daytime, I say, see many windows use curtain. I say, if you use this glass, you don't need curtain because the indoor, the brightness is very suitable for our eyes, very healthy. Also, another issue, all the day, because you can see all the spectrum, especially UV spectrum, all transfer to electricity. So all day, no UV can get into the house. So in your country, maybe some people have a problem of a skin problem. And I think if you use the glass, when you living inside all the day, the furniture and the human will become very healthy indoor. Yeah, this is a real application in Taiwan. Okay, about the environmental issue, every country, maybe Australia signed the contract of Paris. So every country do a lot of effort to how to decrease CO2. I just do a simulation. Before the simulation, I want to tell you that in our technology, in our testing, we do a testing of real monitoring for the house, and we also do the simulation. So we compare the simulation result and the monitoring result. The error is between 5 to 10%. So I can see this simulation is very accurate. Okay, this is a building in Taipei. We see all the year for 1,800 square meter on the wall and the skylight, it can generate 98,000 kilowatt hour per year. Yeah. And for air conditioning, it can save in 74. And for heating system, it can save in 27. Because in Taiwan, we are different from here. during the winter time, it's not so cold. So for the environment issue, for this building, it can save in 103,000 kilowatt hour per year and generate 98,000 kilowatt per year for 1,800 square meter building. So the energy efficiency for full year is 20,000. Okay, that is, and the CO2 decreasing is the figure 141. Yeah, okay. This is for one building. Okay, about the economic assessment. Everybody try to know. The behavior is good, but how about the cost, the money? And I do this assessment just is based on the real situation in Taiwan energy policy. For example, this one. This the high 8 meter skylight, and totally we use 252 piece of glass, and based on the energy policy, we can sell the electricity to get money from the government, and we can also saving the electricity due to we have a very good insulation. So combine this together, the feedback year is 4.23, and the ROI is 18%. But in Taiwan, this is a simulation case for 4,000 piece for 20 floor vertical building. If you use this, because the angle of sine and combining the saving of air conditioning and the power generation, and the feedback year is 8, and the ROI is 7.6%. How about the wind pressure? We send the piece 1.1 to 1.4 meter to Japan to do the testing. It can up to 8,000 psi. And for typhoon is 5,700. So our glass can bear the strong typhoon in Taiwan. Also, we can do the fire testing. And this is the test result I just tell you. Compared with the ordinary glass, during 30 seconds, it will break. But because our glass, we have many layers. We have many layers and also laminate together. So it can 90 minutes and 27 minutes to full break. So real application. From 2011 is the first application for our government. It's a demonstration building. And it's a skylight for a very, very rich person in Taiwan. So when I install the glass on the roof, he said, you can say any money, I can do it. So I thank you for Discovery Channel, because originally this is in 2011, they tried to use a Germany panel, and when she see the Discovery Channel, she said, yeah, it's in Taiwan, we have a local production, so visit my factory, visit my laboratory, and finally she decided to use our glass on the roof. And it's a MRT station, greenhouse of the USA, and this skylight for the school, and the vertical window in my university. And also another choice, it's suitable for human, also suitable for plants. It is a greenhouse in Thailand. You see, we use our power generation to use the electricity for the greenhouse, so you can see the plant grows very well. Otherwise, for the normal glass or normal material, all the plants grows not so good due to so hot. The water go out. So it's approved. This also can apply on the greenhouse. And this is another application. About the international cooperation, maybe we can do in the future. This is I got the Mercury Award during 2014 to 2015. And I go to Nottingham University to do a demo base in the campus. My target is how to develop development of heat insulation solar glass for low carbon building in Europe. So I stayed there 2 years, and we have a many cooperation with the UK company. So this is our demo house in the Nottingham University. The big contribute is in UK, there are many people, they use the like a sunny house and the yard, but during the winter time, it's a lot of heating consumption. So you need to do insulation, otherwise you will lose a lot of energy. And our glass can generate electricity, also can keep warm during the winter time. So the UK company interesting for our product because we do a simulation for him. It can reduce only 1/5 power required from grid. It's in China, it's also a demo house. And this is a recent big project in Dubai. Due to the you say in Dubai is a middle place between Asia and Europe. There are many passenger transit there. So the Dubai government say they need a bigger one, the biggest one in the world. Also thank you Discovery Channel. The king of the Dubai see the watch the TV and ask to CEO to Taiwan to find me and send an email to me. I say, maybe it's a joke, but they'll really come. They'll really come to in this year, visit my factory. I feel very surprised, but it's quite different because they'll take the airlines, Arranger. Okay. They'll take the first class to visit me, but I take the economic class to visit him. So quite difference, yeah. And yes, so they visit Taiwan and ask me to give a talk in the team. The team of the construction of the airport is, there are many people from Europe, Germany, so they try to understand the structure of the glass and the capability. And they come to Taiwan to do trading negotiating in Taipei. And at the end of the month, we try to go there because in Dubai, there are a lot of the power consumption concentrated in the city. For example, in Kuwait, it's 85% energy consumption in the city because the other area is a desert. So he say the glass, the window, if it is in the facade or in the roof, is a solution for the city power consumption. So in this at the end of the month, we try to do many things. One is the headquarter of the Electric Water Authority and also the airport. So finally, this time I came here, I tried to find some possibility for cooperation you and the Earth, you and the Earth in the future. So the first, I need to do some assessment. The assessment also the same skylight is a 25 by 25 square meter. Yeah. You are the second in the world for solar power because almost sunny day. When I came here, I realized why. Because always sun is on the sky, but it's not like this in Taiwan. But in Dubai, every day, but Dubai is very hot. And about the, when you use our glass, the cooling and the heating consumption, we can save in 56 in Sydney, and can save in 69 in Dubai, because the Dubai is always hot all the year, so it can save in more air conditioning. But I feel very exciting is when combine these two together, in Sydney, you can save more. I try to know the reason because you have a stable sunny day. And also, your winter time and the summer time, the temperature difference is big. For my glass, the glass is a very good insulator. So when the outdoor environment is very cold or very hot, it's do a very good job. So it's a very good 86%. I do this assessment 2 years ago. Not only for this trip I do this, but I don't have an opportunity to come here to tell you the result. But now I came here, I have the opportunity to tell you, yes, in Sydney, it's really very good to promote this window, this glass. Another is, Anita tell me, his solar cell can generation both sides. I think it's very good because the sun will go east to the another side, so it can generate solar power when you're in the battery. And another is when you put the glass on the facade, there are many, many small power plants in Australia. Yeah, so also another issue is you can protect the human being, the protect the furniture because zero UV. And this is my idea for your consideration. In Australia, there are many city concentration, and another place is not so many people. So when you will develop an efficiency power supply system, I think is the best way to like a local power system. For example, in Dubai, they use a solar power station here, and send the power to the city, but it's a long distance. The long distance, we need where the power efficiency will lose. So why we try to on the vertical, when we apply on the vertical, every building become a small power generation station, and also it can do a very good heat insulation and can save in energy consumption. If every building here, it can supply energy by themselves or very, very low, I think it is a very good solution for the city. Okay, this is a new style of designer building. This is I suggest for your application. You can use the 50% see-through for the vertical window. Yeah, and also all the solar power generation, you can store in the battery or connect to the grid. and on the skylight all the day. You don't need to turn on the light. You can save in lighting because during the day it's all bright. The music for relax for everybody. And there are three living room, there are three bedroom. And when you sleep, you can not so hot. And you can see the sky. And during the daytime, you don't need to turn on the light. And a very comfortable light. And also, when you take a bath, you can see the sky and very happy when you take a bath. And you can combine the traditional solar panel together and with the glass together. Okay. Oh. Everybody maybe wake up. Okay. This is this simulation we do in Taiwan climate. Only July and August, we need to supply more power. And the other months, we have enough power to supply because it's a very good insulation and very bright during the daytime. You can save in lighting power. And also, you see, all the oil consumption is focused on the blue, is a cooling, and the red color is heating. So all the year, when you use this kind of construction, you can save in 9,000 kilowatt hour per year. Okay, this is the end of my presentation because when the Discovery Channel, you see this is a 4 minutes broadcast, but 6 hours, 6 hours for interview. So from 3 p.m. to 9 p.m. At the night. So finally, they asked me a question, why you try to develop this kind of window or glass? I say, my duty is I try to let the next generation have a better life in the future, not impacted by the global warming. This is my idea. So I come here also the same idea. I hope. We have a cooperation in the future and do a very good environment for our next generation. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Questions? Thanks for that talk. I want to ask about the when you have a vertical facade. You said there was an 8-year payback time period. But if you had a vertical facade, would it be better to not have the solar glass on both sides of the building because one side would be usually shaded, and perhaps you could use the double glazing on that side for a lower cost, and would that improve the payback time?
Yeah, actually, you see, the glass is a. It can generate power. During the cloudy day or on the because the sunshine is you can generate power, but during the cloudy day you still have power. Yeah. So because the spectrum is full from UV to infrared. For example, we apply this in UK, and they have no for east and the west and the south and the north during the cloudy day. All have power and almost the same because all the light is reflected from the earth. But for your country, I suggest if you try to reduce the payback year or to increase the ROI, I suggest the north and the east and the west. Yeah, north. In Taiwan, we are south. Here, you need north. You can get better. And for the south here, you can use a normal Loi glass to reduce the cost, and then you can get a less feedback year. Yeah. Thank you.
Can you mention about the lifetime and degradation of your solar window?
Yeah. The guarantee is 25 years, and every year decrease 1%. That is the same as other PV panel. But for the structure, it's a window. It can keep there all your life. According to 1% decrease, 1% 1 year decrease 1%. After 100 year, no power. But I think our life not longer than 100 years, so no problem. So, but it can stand there, no problem for the wind. Yeah, it's the same as a, but it's a stronger than ordinary glass because three glass. There, this two glass and this glass. And we have a very strong wind pressure up to 8,000. Yeah.
Yes. I think after you add your insulation layer to insulate the heat, then the heat that that generate on the solar panel can be dissipated to the air outside. Then is it possible that you could lose some efficiency of your solar cell because it's too hot? You block the sunlight, so the room is quite cool, but the solar cell is a bit too hot. Then you lose some power.
Yeah, you are expert. Yeah, yeah, really. But you see, we can reflect the light to increase the power. They also after the temperature increase, the semiconductor, the efficiency will go down. But combine these two together, we can increase solar power. Yeah, because the effect is more than the temperature effect. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Have you considered or made the comparison that with your innovative solar window and also a normal solar panel, but with a blind behind it? That because the blinds are white, also can reflect some light into the panel. Also, you don't have that much of heat. You don't have that much of the heat accumulating inside your solar panel. So maybe have you made that kind of comparison?
I don't understand. 比如说像百叶窗这些东西，那个热就不会影响到。 那个我们的那个太阳电板。
Yeah, you mean you see the photo is a normal PV and is a screen here?
In your house, and you install the panel as your window, but also you install a blind behind it, a white blind behind it.
Yeah, yeah, right.
For example, in during the noon, it's too white, too bright, then you just roll down the blind, and the blind can also reflect the light back to your panel. Mm.
Yeah.
Like a mirror.
Yeah, you can try many possibility. I also try a kind of there is a reflection glass in the factory. You can also put the reflection glass in the back. This is a theory, and you can do many possibility together.
Yeah, and then comparing to your fully integrated window glass, solar window. So which one saves more energy?
Okay, every element we install in the glass. So you use the blind, it will separate. And another is this reflection layer is a special material. It is not like the blind. The blind or is a special material. It's coated by silver. And it can reflect back the infrared, and it can increase the solar power. Mm. So you need to choose the material on the back. Yeah.
Also, you don't want to sacrifice the see-through effect.
Yeah.
We may have a future discussion later, because I have been in this car to Anita.
Yeah. Yeah, just a quick one. I think you mentioned that you had different levels of see-throughness of your glass. Like some were 5%, 10%, 50%. Is that correct?
Yeah, there are many 5% and the 10%, 20%, 50%.
All the experiments that you've done so far, have they been on the 50% glass or?
You mean the power generation? Yeah. 10%. Yeah. So you a real application, we use 10% on the roof for skylight with 50% for see-through for vertical. This is our architecture in Taiwan. For example, use this to more power generation for 10%. Most of the time, we see through this vertical. So use a 50% and a 10% see-through on the roof to get the best optimization.
Thank you.